Welcome to today's video. As you know, in our previous video, we look at the different types of electric motors that we have today in industrial settings. That is for AC motors. We look at synchronous and asynchronous motors. In the same vein, we also look at special motors, which are servo motors. Finally, we ended off looking at the different types of DC motors we have today. The way this motor are designed was looked at, and their application. In this new series, we will be looking at how these motors are generally wired. So without any further ado, let's dive in. So that is it, Laura. But before, we will look at the motor that might be suited for some application, which are in terms of speed or torque. There is a need to also look at the winding type.
I was about to say that too. By design, electric motors are usually wound in two forms, which are distributed and concentrated windings.
Yes. There are majorly two types of motor windings. So by design, in concentrated windings, the coil is usually wound on a single stator tooth. While in distributed windings, the coil is usually wound on two or more stator teeth.
So looking at these two motors here, on the one hand, is a motor with concentrated windings, while on the other hand is a motor with distributed winding. As we can see here, the coil of this motor is wound on a single tooth. This means that it does not cover the other teeth. But in distributed windings, the coil is wound on two or more teeth. That means the coil overlapped to two or more teeth.
Perfect, Mike. With this design here, motor with concentrated winding tends to have less ohmic losses than motor with distributed coils.
So during design work, or let's say during the coil windings, the odds of making mistake are very low because the start and the end of the coil are wound on a single tooth.
The possibility of a mistake is relatively low, which is because the wound coil can be visually seen at distance. And an example of such is what we can see here.
Because the coils can be seen on the individual teeth at distance, the connection that needs to be done after the coil has been wound will not be difficult, because the possibility of making mistake is relatively low. Hence the reason.
Of course, those highlighted points are going to be a reverse case when dealing with distributed windings, because the coil is going to be wound on two or more coils. The possibility of making mistakes is very high, because special care must be taken when connecting the start and end of the coil during motor termination.
Also, looking at this wound coil at glance, it will be very difficult to identify the complete path of the coils. Now let's carry out an experiment on both motors, so that we can understand the performance of these two motors. Now, when the motor is rotated by hand, the waveform that is generated by the motor with concentrated winding is trapezoidal in form. While when the same test is repeated with a motor with distributed windings, the waveform is perfectly sine-shaped.
This slope here means that, at the point where the permanent the rotor is starting from rest position up until the point it moved through the air gap, till it cut the wounded teeth. This display waveform represents the axial rotation of the rotor displacement. However, when looking at the distributed windings and also when looking at this waveform here, The rotor starts from rest position and the gradual rise of the slope depicts the rotor movement that cut across the air gap up until it reaches the midpoint between the two or more wound teeth. After which, it gradually drops off exponentially.
Perfect, Guy. Again, looking at these two waveforms here. Motor with a trapezoidal waveform will deliver a great deal of torque when compared to a motor with distributed windings.
In concentrated windings, sine wave back EMF can be achieved by adjusting the rotor design. However, the losses in the copper and sheet are a little bit higher than the distributed wound motor. This is due to more spatial harmonics in the air gap. While a motor with distributed winding achieves higher efficiency, this is due to the produced sine wave back EMF. In addition, it provides efficient cooling. And the dynamic of the motor is balanced. Inductive reactance is lesser with motor with distributed windings. This is because L is proportional to N square. Overall, the armature reaction is more dominant. So there you have it. Now back to your question. If your project requires less torque and more speed, then the induction motor may be a preferred option. However, if it required more torque, then a synchronous motor is preferred. Again, it is important to note that synchronous motors are known to be a little bit more expensive than induction motors. In the coming series, we will be looking at electric motor winding processes. The step and the technique that are used during motor windings processes will be looked at. And finally, we will be looking at how the coil ends are terminated after the coils have been wound. Hope you have learned something new today. See you at the next one.